Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make an easy pie graph using the graph tool in Adobe Illustrator. So first, let's come over here to the column graph tool. You'll see it right down here, and you can choose pie graph. And when you do that, it just gives you a cursor, and I usually just draw a box holding shift, and then it will give you this Excel sheet looking document. Here you can type in all of the values that equal 100. Okay, so let's type in 25, 27, 31, and 17. Those four values equal 100. And so you can see it's already split them up perfectly in a graph. I'll just close this and then get your V tool. Make a copy of this graph so you have it for live data. You can change colors and that kind of thing in here, but I like to just expand it out because there's some weird stuff going on in appearance when I use the graph tool. So we'll go up to Object, Flatten Transparency, and then say okay. This stuff doesn't really matter. It will automatically do what you need it to do. These graphs come in standard with a black outline, and when you expand it, it converts it to a fill. So the thing I do is just click on the black part. It'll always have a black part in it. And then select same fill color. And that gets all of those little black outlines. Then with your G tool, that is your command plus, I mean your group selection tool, you can just hold shift and click the main black part. Now that part's unselected, then you hit delete to get rid of all those little black outlines in between. So now we can go ahead and change colors if we want. I'll make this some kind of variations of green and yellow, just so they have a sort of similar feeling. I like my pie graphs to have a white middle, so I just add a circle and we'll make this white. So now we can center align. I'm going to change align to selection and we'll align horizontally and vertically. Now you have a quick, easy pie graph. This takes about 2 minutes and is so easy. At this point, if you're making an infographic, you can use your pen tool to make some callouts to say what is inside there. I've got a white fill right now, so I'm going to hit the question mark. And so I only have a black fill. And we can say 27%. I'll change this to one of my favorite fonts, which is Montserrat. Bold. And maybe make this a little smaller. I'm holding shift, command, and the comma button to move that up and down. And then in my character palette, we can go here to the baseline shift and move it up. And with my A tool, I'll bring this over. And then here you can have a little description or whatever you needed to have. And if you ever needed to change the values, you still have this live version. If you ever needed to change your values, you could come up here to Object, Graph, and go to Data. And here you can change to whatever you need. But this one, you no longer have access to that data. So that's why I keep a version off to the side that I can easily change and redo. And that's my simple tip for the day. This is Anne for Graphic Design How To. If you liked this video, please click the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please hit subscribe. And be sure to leave any comments or problems you're having in the comments section below. Thanks, guys.